We have received lots and lots of information from a counsellor who works in the Marriage and Divorce Department at the Jabatan Pendaftaran Negara. And according to her, in the statistics, financial problems are top on the list. Then comes third party and mother-in-laws and whatsoever not. Today we are here, standing in front of here is Mr. Mahesh's house, who is a lecturer who works in one of the universities. Let's ask him what he thinks, what is bad for marriage. Not me. Alright, now we're here with Mr. Mahesh from the academic line. So, Mr. Mahesh, tell us, what is bad for marriage?
It really depends on what is bad, what is good, how you define that. I think at the end of the day, when you take each other for granted, I think that's where the whole problem starts.
Alright, top on the list is on Facebook is mother-in-laws are big problems. They give bad hard times. Do you think so too?
Oh, of course not. I wouldn't agree with that because my mother-in-law has been staying with me for about 6-7 years now, and it's such a wonderful thing. But I guess there must be some truth to it because let's say like my mother, she had some problems with her mother-in-law, not real problems, but like I said, if you have two ladies staying in the same house, let's say a daughter-in-law and a mother-in-law, there's bound to be conflict, especially if let's say the mother-in-law is not working, she's housewife, and the daughter-in-law works. I know daughter-in-law is probably from this generation. She goes out, she has friends, she wants to go for a movie and those kind of things. Those things that young people do, there's going to be tremendous amount of conflict. And there could be an understanding between the man and the woman that says, hey, you know, doesn't matter, you don't have to make coffee for me in the morning, fine, I'll just get up and go to work and eat something. But the mother-in-law will be like, hey, you know, why are you doing this? You know, remember when I was... So there's always going to be that comparison between the mother-in-law and daughter-in-law. So, but I think in most cases, if, like in my case, let's say the mother-in-law stays and you're the son-in-law, and I guess you're treated like a king. It's different. But I think two ladies in one house, one household, usually is a bad idea, no matter how good it is. Because you see, like when my wife has an argument with her mother, it's mother and daughter. But if a daughter-in-law has an argument with the mother-in-law, then it's different. It's like an outsider. So how do you solve this problem? It's a bit difficult. As long as both individuals know how to keep out of each other's hair, so they have a boundary, okay, this is the boundary, my son is married or my daughter is married and I stay out of this, don't get involved, don't tell how things are supposed to be done or how things were good in the old days and all that, then things will work out pretty well, which is quite impossible. You know, it's impossible to do that unless you stay in two separate houses. Whatever goes on in your house and whatever goes on in that person's house is, you know, you can probably share certain things, but it doesn't become to an extent where you feel compelled that I must say something. So I think the solution to the problem is try as much as possible to say separately. But sometimes the cases are where the mother-in-law is like, you know, she's old and there's no one to take care of. And I think that's where the daughter-in-law has to take a little bit more responsibility. And she has to, unfortunately, she has to swallow her pride and, you know, understand that this person is old and this is someone I should respect, someone I should win her heart over. Because it's difficult for a person who's very old to change her ways. But for a younger person, you know, she can probably say, okay, fine, this person is difficult, but I'll find a way. It's like a challenge. And eventually get into the mode where you feel that your mother-in-law is like your mother. So I think the challenge is that it's that ego which gets in the way sometimes. So that's the problem.
All right, thank you so much. Hi. Wait, no, not hi. But now with me is a professional, a working woman, and also a mother to two. She is Nurlin. And let's ask her, what is bad for marriage?
Hello, hi. I think what's bad on marriage would be... like everybody said, most of it is probably mother-in-law's thing. But I do believe, like, it's actually both husband and wife, you know, they really have to work out on it. Of course, family, siblings, important. But I believe loyalty lies in your spouse. Okay, and second thing, I think it's been probably maybe letting go of yourself. You know, sometimes when you are too comfortable with each other, you don't have time to really, you know, probably you think, oh, my husband doesn't care how I look like, you know, but it is actually very important. You have to take care of yourself. You know, you want to look good to your husband even after you get married, you know, not just during, you know, courting days and stuff. And the third one, I think, spending too much time with your friends, probably doing something you love the most, and you think that it is okay for your spouse to, you know, you spend time with your things like your hobbies and whatnot, you know. And the next one in my list, I think, probably financial thing, yeah. And
finally, we have come to our last interviewee. It has been an eventful day for all of us. Today we have here now is Mr. Lee. Mr. Lee is a husband, a father to three, and a grandfather to two grandchildren. And so Mr. Lee, what is your opinion on what is bad for marriage?
Thank you, Ms. Chanda. I can put into three categories. One is financial management. Two, communications. And third is not faithful to one another. So you're talking about having extramarital affairs. These, I believe, three are the bad things for marriage.
Okay, Mr. Lee, do you have any advice for newly wedded couples out there or couples who are going to get married?
Yes, I think religion plays a very important part in our lives, because when you were to raise the children, they have to be God-fearing, and we teach them the eternal laws of God, of trustworthiness as mentioned earlier, of equality between men and women, and respect one another. Physical union, as I mentioned to you, has been so much emphasize, but we fail to look on the spiritual aspect of it. That's where religion comes a very important part in our life. So a person could be a Buddhist or a Hindu or a Christian or even a Baha'i for the matter, and that will be the foundation. And there's one statement made by one of the great teachers, world educator. He says that marriage is a fortress of well-being. So when you think about it and you reflect upon why that it's been said that a marriage is a fortress of well-being, the sense that, no, it is where you get the protection as well as the sanctuary, as well as you develop each other. You know, when both come together, it's either the best out of you or the worst out of you can come out together. So when you commit one another as a spiritual union, you always bring out the best. And it takes a lot of effort to nurture and develop the relationship. Not just to that it's only just the husband or the wife to do it, but both parties to have that. And also, when you raise children, no, the purpose of marriage is the advancing of civilization. So when you train your kids, your children, to be good, they will be the examples for society, and society will benefit when they have been upright citizens of the country. And when you look at all the problems the society is facing, it's that lack of spiritual education. So when parents get together, they must educate themselves spiritually and impart the education, religious education, to their children as well.
All right, thank you so much, Mr. Lee, for your time. Now that we have received a lot of information and advices from many talented people, it is for you to decide what is bad for marriage, and it is in your hand to change all these bad things into good things. Like once a wise man said, marriage is a fortress for well-being and salvation. With that, we wish you all a happy married life from Gregs TV.